As you probably heard by now, Reverend Ted Haggard, president of the 30 million member National Association of Evangelicals, I'm sure there's an acronym for that, resigned his post this weekend after admitting to a 3-year sexual relationship with a gay hooker.
In the Bible Belt of Middle America, evangelical Christians are fighting back against science.
Our Father,
our Father,
who art in heaven,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
In the New World, religion is free enterprise. Rival groups set up shop on every street corner, competing to save people's souls and collect their money. Fundamentalist Christianity is on the rise among the electorate of the world's only superpower, right up to and including the president. If you believe the surveys, 45% of Americans, that's about 135 million people, believe the universe is less than 10,000 years old. This is the New Life Church in Colorado Springs, where conservative Christians have built an $18 million worship center as their New Jerusalem in the foothills of the Rocky Mountains. Evangelical churches like this have become a powerful lobby, exerting enormous influence on everything in America, from the teaching of science in schools to foreign policy. This place strains belief. It isn't just a church, but a ready-made social network. The 12,000-strong congregation can also attend 1,300 organized programs where they can meet to exchange Christian tips on everything from marriage to dog walking. It's all terribly exuberant and intense. The pastor is Ted Haggard, a powerful man, chairman of the National Association of Evangelicals, and the New Life is Ted's Evangelical Vatican.
Welcome to all of our friends. We'll take a moment and say hello to the people behind you, in front of you, and to your right, to your left. Hey, we want to welcome all of you that are visiting here with us today. If you're here for the very first time, we have a packet of information that we want to give to you. And so all of you visitors, if you would please...
Sadly, the warmth of the welcome would prove short-lived when I started talking to Pastor Haggard about the Bible and scientific fact.
You'll find yourself wrong on some things, right on some other things. But please, in the process of it, don't be arrogant.
We exalt you here this morning, Lord God. Everything that's within us wants to give you praise and glory and honor, because we are so grateful...
Pastor Ted Haggard has a hot line to God and to George Bush. A staunch Republican, he claims he has a weekly conference call with the president and has also rubbed shoulders with Tony Blair and Ariel Sharon.
Well, that was really quite a show you gave us today. A fair bit of money seems to have been spent here.
Yes.
I wanted people to be able to worship and enjoy it and then be in a setting where the speaker is close to them. That's why it's in the round. And so they can be up close to me and so I can look at them.
Well, it's certainly very effective what you do. I mean, it seemed to me to have all the arts of... I mean, I was almost reminded, if you'll forgive me, of a sort of Nuremberg rally. I mean, such incredibly... Dr. Goebbels would have been proud.
I don't know anything about the Nuremberg rallies, but I know lots of Americans think of it as a rock concert.
What can I give to you that you don't already have?
We fully embrace the scientific method as American evangelicals, and we think as time goes along, as we discover more and more facts, that we'll learn more and more about how God created the heavens and the earth.
The scientific method clearly demonstrates that the world is 4.5 billion years old. I mean, do you accept that?
Yeah, you know what you're doing is you are accepting some of the views that are accepted in some portions of the scientific community as fact. Sometimes it's hard for a human being to study the ear or study the eye and think that happened by accident.
I beg your pardon, did you say by accident?
Yeah.
What do you mean by accident?
That the eye just formed itself somehow.
And who says it did?
Well, some evolutionists say it.
Not a single one that I've ever met.
Really?
Really.
Oh.
You obviously know nothing about the subject of evolution.
Or maybe you haven't met the people I have. But you see, you do understand. You do understand that this issue right here of intellectual arrogance is the reason why people like you have a difficult problem with people of faith. I don't communicate an air of superiority over the people because I know so much more. And if you only read the books I know, and if you only knew the scientists I knew, then you would be great like me. Well, sir, there could be many things that you know well. There are other things that you don't know well. As you age, you'll find yourself wrong on some things, right on some other things. But please, in the process of it, don't be arrogant.
We just had a rather disconcerting experience. We were just packing up our stuff ready to go, and he suddenly drove up in his pickup truck and said, "Get off my land immediately. I'll have you thrown in jail. I'll seize your film." And he then said a very curious thing. He said, "You called my children animals." Afterwards, we worked out that what he must have meant was that I talked about evolution.
And he also purchased and used crystal meth. Because if you're the head of a gay-hating organization and you're having a gay affair, why not go nuts? What are you going to say? Like, geez, I'm dating a gay hooker there, but drugs? I don't know. As it happens, conveniently enough, Haggard can currently be seen in theaters in the documentary Jesus Camp. I have faith we have an unbelievably ironic clip of that.
We don't have to debate about what we should think about homosexual activity. It's written in the Bible. I think I know what you did last night. If you send me $1,000, I won't tell your wife.
Haggard was exposed by a male escort named Mike Jones, who said he was troubled by the hypocrisy of Haggard's public support of a Colorado initiative to ban same-sex marriage. And you know you're in trouble when you've ceded the moral high ground to a drug-dealing prostitute. You know what, Reverend Haggard? Meet me at camera. You know what? Forget that. I think I have another camera we can meet at that might make you feel more comfortable. Hey. Hey. What's up? How's it going? Hey, man. It's our glory hole cam. Found it at the Vince Lombardi rest stop on the New Jersey Turnpike. Now, Reverend, you may wonder why people are taking pleasure, some would say glee, in the idea of an anti-gay activist being, you know, gay. First of all, people like you make it really hard for, quite frankly, people like you. See, here's a little piece of advice for you and for anyone else out there in your situation. Let me put this in terms that you can understand. Here's you, and here's gay. Gay works out. You cannot run from gay. Now, you can't catch gay, but gay sure as hell can catch you. So, Ted, look at the view from here. It's not so great. But once you stop trying to outrun gay, you can catch your breath and realize the world's actually a pretty nice place. See? There's glory all around you, Reverend.
Yo.